All right, boys, let's do it. Taking stock.
Nah.
Taking stock. The stock is being taken. What are we gonna buy and sell? You know what's a little fucking crazy? I'm gonna fucking say something. You may be like, holy shit, Coco. You're a fucking madman. I can't fucking believe it. All right? I have more buys than sells this week. All right?
Good job.
The big buy, buy or sell. Yuta Tsuji. I always fuck up that name, the TSU. I've been living here in Japan. The TSU sound fucking drives me crazy. But Yuta Tsuji went and battled against Will Ospreay because I was at the video game show working hard and trying to expand everything. I did not be able to review it, but I watched it. You know what's cool? A bunch of us got together to watch just that match. He is the future of New Japan. Him and Will Ospreay had another match of the year candidate. I have no idea what you rate matches on, but I say it's a must watch. And he gives hope. And in all his Japanese interviews, he's like, I know New Japan's down, but I'm going to carry it. And it reminds me of the days of a young Nakamura, a young Okada, a young Tanahashi. So Yuta Tsuji, Will Ospreay, must watch, and New Japan.
I mean, it's a Will Ospreay match. Aren't they all must-watches now?
Yuta Tsuji has... He has the cool factor. He has the star power. He's already doing Rolling Stones. He's already over. And for a young guy, he was part of that amazing A block. And on top of the A block being the best block, he's had all good matches. I've only seen one bad thing by him. And it was he was doing an attack. And he saw that the senior wrestlers were lazy. So he was lazy. Yoda, you don't change. You change them. But overall, I think if he doesn't get injured, he's going to be a fucking star. He is the future. I would put all the fucking money on him because everyone else, we just pretend they're fucking good. Let's be honest. Oh yeah, fucking Taguchi, he's going to be the fucking future. Oh yeah, Shaw, oh yeah, he's fucking the future. Stop fucking lying to yourselves! So hopefully Tsuji is the one. And we'd love to see him. I would also like to say, big guy, stylish guy, stiff guy, can move fast, and even Will Ospreay put him over saying, if you're the future of New Japan, it's bright. But, you know, New Japan has never dipped down a day in his life. It's always been perfect. You know that. All right, your first buy or sell?
Julia Hart. I'm buying Julia Hart.
What? Okay, I got a new sell. I'm selling her. Go ahead. Why are you buying her?
I've been high on her for a while, but I think Julia Hart is a great homegrown talent, and I think it's great that they're giving her this attention and time. I don't know if she's going to beat Statlander, but I would like to see her beat Statlander just because I think she's more interesting right now.
Yeah, I think with what's her name? Jumping ship. I apologize. I got concussions. With Jade Berg. Her jumping. Jade Berg jumping. I think Statlander got lost in the sauce.
I do too.
I think her winning might spike something up and also will make the factions do better. I'm not as high on her as you, but I mean, they're doing worse things in the women's division.
She's really young. She's learning really well. And the spider gimmick in the corner where she's doing spider suplexes, dodges, stuff. I just think that's a really cool gimmick.
Yeah. I'm buying New Japan. I know I just bought Tsuji, but I'm buying New Japan because in the Japanese articles, they mention that they're going to build back up. And I like when a company realizes that they have to build back up because it gives fans hopes. And for the longest time, they were just not acting like they have to build back up. So now with Tsuji promos and New Japan promos, I hope they build back up. Do you have a buy or sell? Or should we go all positive and save the negative for last?
I don't know. I feel like you already did some selling out. It sounds
I got two more buys.
A few buys. How much selling out you got left, though? Probably all out.
All right.
They did all of it.
By Noah Magic, they're trying to do a weekly TV show, and they're going bi-weekly. I would love to see Shinjuku face every Monday night, like a Monday Night Raw thing. Just call it Monday Magic. Do I like the name? No. They said it's going to be like a serial drama. They're doing two episodes. I don't know. Like, this could either blow up in their face or could save the company. But let me tell you. Take a chance. Take a chance. There you go. And I have a buy that... We talked about this in the podcast already. But buy Roderick Strong. I love Roderick Strong. I despise the sports entertainment. But I hate that I love it so much. Adam! And then the sells, negatives. I just feel like we make these taking stocks. And I'm starting to think Tony Khan, Vince McMahon, Ghetto, Cyberfight. No one watches these. So
I don't think so, because Ghetto's still booking multi-man matches.
That's my sell.
And I know I've sold them. Oh, good.
I've got to sell again.
My sell. But I didn't get to do it because you railroaded me and you did 18 buys in a row.
Well, YouTube told me you put the positive.
I'm selling you, hogging all the buying selling time.
Yeah. All I'm saying is YouTube told me you got to put the positives up front. You got to put the positives up front.
What does YouTube know about making videos?
I don't know. They always have these fucking ideas about editing and fucking tricking the viewers and thumbnails and be positive. Dude, let me tell you.
I'm gonna start hiding dick pics in the thumbnails.
YouTube would fucking absolutely love if you never said anything negative. They would. They'd just be like, dude, why don't you just say everything is awesome? Maybe that's why there's so many fucking... Man, that's why there's so many assholes on YouTube saying everything is awesome.
Maybe.
Maybe they're just like, fuck it, dude. Yeah, dude. Yeah, that's fucking awesome. Everything's amazing. All right. Contract signings. Bam! Sell it. Tony Khan did not get the fucking message. There you go. Contract signings. And then I signed...
Buying cliffhangers.
What's that?
Buying cliffhangers.
Oh, cliffhangers.
There need to
be
more segments in wrestling that make me excited for the next show.
Yeah.
That aren't announcements of what's coming.
Yeah. And sell announcements of announcements. That's
you already did that.
Guess what? They're not listening. They're not fucking listening.
Yeah, you did it this time, though.
Oh, did I? Well, I'm going to say
it again.
I'm saying it
like
again.
Like 5 minutes ago, you sold
But the cliffhangers I kind of like. I really liked how AEW went off the air this week. AEW Dynamite. That's
well, except for the fact they jumped back to Paige for like 3 seconds. That didn't make sense.
Oh, I thought that was bonus coverage.
Nah, I think that was a fuck up.
Oh, that sucks. Yeah, because we get bonus coverage. So a lot of times when I just see someone standing in a ring, I just assume it's
maybe,
just bonus
maybe it
coverage.
Was. Maybe that. Maybe
did you watch the international feed or did you watch it on DBS?
Maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, if you watch it on international feed, there's a good chance they always show you bonus bullshit. And back in the day, we used to get bonus matches. Those days are over. Those days are over. Jesus. So, yeah. And then I wrote something. Let's play the old What Did Dave Write?
Oh, God, is that a poem?
No. That word right there. Okay, I'm bringing it really close to the screen.
I can't see your screen.
Well, then you're going to have to watch the podcast on YouTube Coco Sports. What does that say?
Damn it.
Pro... I don't know.
Pro wrestling.
I'm selling my handwriting. My handwriting is fucking garbage.
You're selling pro wrestling Noah.
Maybe.
That's what it says.
It's fucking bit of a fucking rough. I don't know. I'm they still have Kenno. I'm like that guy that's Rocky. Remember Bart? Remember Bart?
Bye,
Krusty is coming. Krusty is coming. That's me.
You need to just
we
get ready. Kenno's going
we
next
still
week.
Have Kenno. No! We still have Kenno.
They're going together.
We still have Kenno. No. We still have Kenno.
Their dream is to find another place where they can tag team strong style.
It's sad in professional sports when you see the perfect team fall apart. It's kind of the same thing in pro wrestling. You know, like New Japan was on top of the world and kind of fell apart. Noah was on top of the world, fell apart. All Japan was on, you know what I mean? I don't know. It always, you know, buy and sell. It always feels great when you're like, oh my God, everything is awesome. This is amazing. And then it falls apart.
Coco, what if that wasn't Switchblade that got attacked?
Who do you think it is?
That was, what if that was Cardblade?
No, they would never attack Cardblade.
I'm just saying, what if it was?
What if the mascot was Cardblade? You ever think about that?
I still stand by that. Why are you... I like how you're acting like that was your idea.
That wasn't my idea! I stole it! I fucking stole it!
I still say it would be hilarious if they just had the mask guy doing stuff, and then one day they unveiled it, and it was just Cardblade underneath it.
Oh, man.
And Cardblade was taking over the Bullet Club.
Old school pro wrestling nerds like me would fucking have a heart attack.
I'd lose it. I'd be like, fucking Cardblade!
It was Cardblade! He betrayed him! It's the guns. The guns and Cardblade.
Yeah. It'd be so, well, no, Juice has to be there. Juice has to be the one to sell why it makes sense.
Yeah.
I need Juice to just give me an unhinged rant about why it made sense.
Also, I'm buying Juice.
Save your grocery list for later.
Exactly. He went to NXT, had a great gimmick, but they didn't have the balls to put the gimmick over. That's one gimmick I'd love. Like, dude, he's a protester. You know how far you could push that if you really gave a shit? You know how far Paul Heyman would have pushed that in ECW? It would have been insane. Then he gives up there, becomes a young lion, becomes one of the most over faces ever. Then he comes to fucking America Bullet Club. It goes like a bag of ass. They make Bullet Club Gold in AEW. And Bullet Club Gold is literally Bullet Club. What North Americans think Bullet Club is that didn't watch. It's like the most American version of Bullet Club ever. And I don't know. I feel like you fucking Americans love this shit. And now they're delivering it. So enjoy.
Well, I mean, I was sold as soon as they got the guns involved. They bought me with that.
Oh, dude, that guns entrance. I've never seen an entrance save someone's career so fast. Like, I saw that entrance, and I'm like, I like these motherfuckers.
And when they did the one where they did it with Cardblade, oh my god, I lost it.
We're Team Cardblade. We're buying Team Cardblade.
Around, and then there's Cardblade. I was like, oh my fucking god, they did not just do this entrance with Cardblade, these motherfuckers.
I'm buying Cardblade. There, I said it.
For Cardblade.
We're buying it. All right. Any final things? Because I'm going to wrap this up. You've been doing this for about 5 hours, and I need to eat spaghetti. Spaghetti I eat a day? I'm insane with the spaghetti. Dude, all the time. Like,
how do you get so much spaghetti in Japan?
Oh, dude, there's like this healthy spaghetti. I don't know if it's true. They say it's healthy. I'm starting to think health food might lie on its packaging.
I mean, it can't be as bad as American food.
So they have health spaghetti, and it comes like in this little tin, and it's just the perfect amount of spaghetti. You know what I mean? It's not, and it's so good. It's so good. Like, I don't know. How do you make the because, like, I don't know. Have you ever noticed this about spaghetti? I'm buying spaghetti. You know what I notice about spaghetti here? The old spaghetti, if you will, is that it's either too little or too much. It's very hard to get the perfect amount of spaghetti. You know, it's like, oh, God, I ate too much, or, oh, fuck, I want more spaghetti. This is the perfect. Like, do you believe in fate? Do you believe in love? Do you believe in perfect matches? I believe in magic. Noah magic every Monday night at Shinjuku Face?
No.
That's a thing.
No.
But I just the spaghetti.
If they wanted
me
to believe in them, they would have kept Nakajima.
I know. God damn it.
Or got Kenta.
Well, here's the thing, too, like, I don't know, Prime Kenta, yeah, Kenta now, I remember, I felt so bad, Kenta came out for the Muda one, and it was like, Kenta's first return to Noah in forever, and one guy goes, welcome home, Kenta, and Noah fans are kind of the smart fans of, you know, of whatever, they're the smarks, whatever, you know, they're the fucking high standard fans. They just turned around. They're like, are you fucking for real? And that was it. That was the end. It's a welcome home, Noah.
How'd you hear all that?
I was there live. I sat in a chair. That's it. I had ears.
You speak Japanese?
No, I don't speak. Don't you fucking dare blow my cover. I've been riding this thing for years. I don't know any Japanese, you son of a bitch. Oh, man. When did you figure it out? I remember, I think we were watching Noah together and you figured it out.
Yeah, you commented on something the commentary said, and I was like, they're in Japanese, Dave.
You're like, listen, I don't know any Japanese, and I'm sticking to it, you sons of bitches. Loser in Japan. Oh, God, dude. Even today, yesterday I was at a video game place, and everyone's talking about learning Japanese, and I kayfabed them. Straight up. I was like, yeah, dude, I don't know any fucking Japanese. Because here's the thing. People are so fucking dumb. If you don't tell them they're Japanese, they'll actually fucking just start speaking in Japanese thinking you don't know. They're like, and then you just got to play it stone cold face. You know, like, here's an example. I'm sitting down in a restaurant. And they're like, I'm going to beat the fuck out of this guy and steal his wallet. I'm like, I got to go. I'm going to go take a piss and never see me again. So not learning Japanese, very important. Pretending you don't know Japanese, even more important. Learning Japanese and bragging about it? Hatui! Disgusting! You're a fucking pervert! Thank you. Sell speaking Japanese.
And sell Nakajima as a free agent.
No! Let me come back. I don't know. Come back to me. Like, dude, if we were allowed.
Maybe he will go back.
Yeah, I mean, it is true. But my thing is, like, if we were allowed to end on a copyrighted song, I'd be like, baby, come back. That's how we'd end it.
No, we would play the na na na.
You son of a bitch. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. And Akshima, wherever you go, no, I'll love you. I'm not a fucking corporate titty fucking rubber. Are you a corporate titty rubber? I don't think you are.
I mean, if I got paid by a corporation to rub titties, I would.
I'd rub titties for money forever.
Be a corporate titty rubber.
Yeah. But I'm saying a corporate titty rubber for free? Oh, weird. Sell them.
I mean, I'd still rub titties for free. Corporate or not?
No, you got to rub your own nipples and go, yeah, I love WWE. Oh, yeah, Jade.
Why do I
want to
rub my own?
Jade and WWE.
No,
oh,
the offer was
Jade and AEW.
Rub just corporate titties. And then now suddenly these corporate titties are my own.
You got to rub your own corporate titties, dude.
I don't have corporate titties.
Now then, you're a good raccoon. I've taught you well.
Yeah, I'm not. Well, I mean, the number one lesson you taught me was always sell out.
I did. You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying, if you're going to be a piece of shit, get paid.
I mean, you're not wrong.
I don't understand being a piece of shit for fucking no money.
We're looking at you, Seth Rollins. We were told you bought in.
I didn't sell out. I bought it.
Again, I mean, he does have that championship still.
Oh yeah.
And it's been burying all the internet darlings.
I just fucking don't understand why that title exists. Is that the most?
So that they can have a title that gets defended regularly.
How about next week? Can we have, for those that made it this far into the podcast, you're the fucking ultimate elite. You are the internet infantry. Second. Let's have a cliffhanger. All right? Shit, I had a good question. Shit, what was the question?
You fucked up. See?
Oh, no. Here it is. I got it. What is the most worthless title in pro wrestling? And is it Seth Rollins? And then we can fucking, like, do some research. And it has to be active. I don't want to be like, all right, I had a fucking TV title from North America East Coast Wrestling.
I would say the 24-hour title.
No, it has to be active. I don't think that's active.
Oh.
Hey, so fucking do your homework. And unless
Seth Rollins is going to win.
Doesn't it have Dom Dom on it?
Yeah.
So you're saying,
still a stupid belt.
All right, well, thank you for fucking ruining my cliffhanger. I tried to fucking AEW this up.
In fact, also, I would add the international title in AEW that's never been defended internationally,
dude,
really.
That drives me fucking nuts.
The AEW domestic title.
All right, so
domestic in Canada.
This was supposed to be next week's segment, but what is the most worthless title in wrestling? And if you're like, I'm a WWE fan, I like don't like AEW. Just know from the bottom of my heart, you're a fucking idiot.
And if you think it's the Coco Sports Twitch title, that's okay too.
Let's be honest, that shit gets passed around a lot. But unlike the Coco Sports title. Not the Twitch title, but the real title. Ooh-wee. Three champions. Had to fucking do it. Have you heard? Coco Sports Dream. Bray Wyatt upset Cody Rhodes. Yeah. You get spoilers late night. you get E-Fed spoilers late night. All right, when we get to E-Fed spoilers, is that time to say goodbye?
Yeah.
Like, comment, subscribe on YouTube, Coco Sports, wherever you're finding this podcast. Throw a couple fucking hearts, a banana or two. Like it, share it. I don't know what you do on your platform, but do it. Just tickle the balls a little bit so it gets the word out. Also, tweet it out. Send it, share it out to your friends. And friends don't let friends be nipple rubbers. Sid's Light is Sid's Light on everything. YouTube, Twitter, Twitch. Make sure to check it out. I'm on everything at Coco Sports. And with that, I am over. Hey, ba-da-bum-bum-bum. Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoop.